as a father that I am with a daughter, this chapter of One Piece honestly hit me very close, because what Pound did in this chapter of One Piece, I could totally see myself now, obviously in different circumstances. Hello, we're not living in a pirate world, but I'd totally be the same way. And honestly, Oda, what you doing, bro? Oda, what you doing to me? Making me get some feels for a side character in a small subplot. Like, bro, Oda, cut it out, bro. Now, this chapter of One Piece, you could argue that in a way, because of the level of not necessarily popularity, but you know, importance that Pound has, maybe you could argue, okay, it wasn't the most important chapter of One Piece, because again, Pound, he's a side character, and Oven, while he's one of the generals, he's not like, you know, one of the main important guys or whatever. But nevertheless, the chapter of One Piece, I felt as though Pound really brought it home, and it was interesting to see how Oda was making the little connections where Capone's kid could, even though he never met Pound or anything like that, he could feel it, you know, like that's grandpa right there and shit like that. So a lot of little neat things with this chapter of One Piece. I'd argue for people, because I know, again, there's going to be people that say they don't care about Pound or whatever, but I'd argue that it did bring forth some progression, because we did get on the ship and we're getting close to solving this problem of basically shoving some food in Big Mom's mouth. You know what I'm saying? Like, yo, man, you crying and screaming and angry because you want some cake. Here's your cake. So we did get progression in that regard, but just a lot of what went down in this chapter, honestly, again, it surprised me. I didn't really think I was gonna give a rat's ass when I'm seeing like Pound and shit like that and everything. I'm just kind of like, what? But like, getting his backstory, I think, was something that was key to making us care about him, because finding out that Big Mom basically had his kids, had his seeds, and said, peace, brudda, peace. Like, yo, I'm gonna be running you for that child support too, Pam. But like, no, it was interesting and sad at the same time. Honestly, Pound lived a tragic life. You know, he had kids with Big Mom. She didn't even let him hold them once, and basically told him, piss off. And you know, that's that. And he was treated like trash. So honestly, Pound, he lived a tragic life to the very bitter end. But what he did, I could do nothing but respect, and it kind of makes me appreciate more. Like, if I was to reread, or in the anime, if I ever go back to the anime, well, occasionally I go back to anime, but if I was to ever revisit this material, I think it would definitely make me appreciate Pound more, and the little moments building up to where we went with Pound in this chapter, because it's like, it hits. It definitely hit. And again, it's a sub-character, you know, subplot, small side character that you didn't really think you would care about. But just him going up against Oven, and Oven being ruthless, it showcases, because I was having a debate the other day with somebody about, like, you know, just what the Big Mom Pirates are, if they're really truly evil, what type of people they are. Personally, I think in chapters like this, yet again, show maybe all of them aren't evil, but a good majority of them are pieces of shit, because at the end of the day, he's related in some form or another, you know what I'm saying? Like, Pound is related, that's Chifon's father. So the fact that Oven mercilessly, you know, took him out, it's kind of like, yeah, maybe in his mind he felt like he was doing the right thing, because it was a whole big betrayal to the Big Mom Pirates. But nevertheless, bro, that's your sister's father. On top of that, that's your sister that he was just beating up on, what, last chapter, whatever. But that's your sister's father, and you just literally did this man Dr. Susia, bro. You did him dirty, and like, R.I.P. Pound. Now, some people are saying, oh no, he's not gonna be dead. If he comes back to life, or he never really died, I'm kinda gonna be like, really, bro? Like, really? Don't get me wrong. I would love for him to have a kind of happy ending, because, again, like I've said, the man had a tragic life. Like, had kids, couldn't even hold them, couldn't be around them. Chifon doesn't even really know who the hell this guy is. She's saying, hey, is he some kind of pervert? Which is like, that's messed up. But at the same time, it was a nice little subtle thing with the grandchild and shit like that, even though Capone's child, like, looks ridiculous. Like, why you got 5 o'clock after shadow? You a baby. What's going on there? But Capone, yet again, from where last one left off, looking badass as hell, going up, not giving a shit, showing that he's a real man, he cares about his family, and I appreciate that. And it kind of shows that if Capone wasn't so slimy and such a, like, you know, a devious guy, well, the Big Mom Pirates are devious too and slimy or whatever, but like, he kind of fits in with the Big Mom Pirates in a sense of like, he's really in a way, now that I think about it, hey, the Big Mom Pirates do stupid shit, and they're fucked up with their family. But, like Katakuri, for example, Capone and Katakuri seem like they would go very well together, because they have a very high importance and caring for family. Look what everything he did for Tifon. Now people will say, like, oh, why are you doing it for that nasty looking bitch, whatever, but like, he cares about his family, bro. So I think that it's interesting that even though Capone betrayed Big Mom and the Big Mom Pirates and with everything that he did, and even Tifon, he does kind of seem very similar to somebody like Katakuri. He cares and truly will ride for his family. You know, I mean, he came through and the odds were stacked against him, but he did it for his family. And it was interesting. I think Capone has been kind of surprising people with all the, not gadgets, but like the little transformations that he could do, like what he did with his own body, turning into the castle and shit, and then what he did with his ship in this one. It showcases that Capone, he's part of the worst generation for a reason. But honestly, looking at this chapter and thinking about it, I was kind of like, you know, he's part of the worst generation, right? But like, in comparison to like Luffy, Capone wouldn't be able to take on somebody like Katakuri. Now, Luffy can't even take on Katakuri, let's not get it twisted, but I've just seen like the difference in them. Like, Capone, he's a strategist, he's really intelligent, he knows how to maneuver, he's a snake and shit like that. But as far as like, you know, power wise, like, I don't think Capone could do what even Luffy's trying to do in Luffy right now, until we get either an awakened, you know, part for his devil fruit or something to do with his haki. He can't even do it. So just kind of like a thought in my mind that honestly, Capone, as cool as he is, he's not on that level of Luffy. But aside from that, other parts of the chapter, we met up with Big Mom is right there on the horizon. We got the cake. It was kind of weird with Sanji, like, kicking the cake or carrying the cake or whatever. It's like, I ain't gonna lie. I'm really ready to be over with this whole freaking cake stuff. Like, or not whole Cake Island, but, like, the whole, you know, making the cake and bringing it to Big Mom. Like, I'm ready for this to be over with. Like, give the fat, gross-ass bitch her cake. And let's move on from that, because it's just like, bro, I didn't get into Toriko. This ain't Shokugeki no Soma, bro. Like, let's carry on from that. So I was glad at the end that Big Mom is on the horizon. Hopefully we're going to get over with that. But overall, the chapter, it was a good chapter. And honestly, if it wasn't for the feels, I think it would have been even less than what it is now. Because again, I could see a big argument of people saying, The majority of the chapter focus on side characters, like, you know, Tifon and her father. And I mean, I think it was executed nicely. And it's nice sometimes that this small subplot of, like, you know, Pound wanting to not necessarily reunite, but be a part of Tifon's life or do something for her and do something for his grandchild, he was able to do it at the cost of his life. So settling that subplot the way it was done was amazing. You know, Oda's one of the few that can make characters that, again, I rewatched, or I watched a little bit of the anime episodes that had him in there, and I was like, I don't give a flying shit about this character. You know what I'm saying? I don't care. And he made me care. By the end of all this, he made me care, and he turned him into a really badass character. R.I.P. to the great father, Pound. Again, it hit me close to home because I'm a father, and I would go above and beyond for my daughter's happiness and shit like that. So to see that this man wasn't even able to be a part of her life, but he did something for her in the end, really cool stuff there. But the chapter overall is like a piece of progression. Hey, we're finally at Big Mom, but in essence, it wasn't like a really big game change or anything. And no Luffy, which that kind of disappointed me as well. It's like, come on, bro. Like, that's the big attraction right now. What's got me really hype about this arc is the Luffy Katakuri situation and Luffy trying to advance. But hopefully off screen, Luffy's making moves so we can get another round with him and Katakuri and he could put him down. But again, as a whole, good chapter. If it wasn't for Pound's sacrifice and getting to Big Mom at the end of the chapter, it wouldn't have been much, because again, not too much happened. I mean, a bit of Capone and little stuff here, but it wasn't the biggest chapter in the world. And honestly, Pound, a side character, made this chapter what it was. Kind of curious what you guys think about it though. For starters, how did you feel about Pound? Did it give you any feels? Do you feel as though, even though it was a side character with a very small subplot, that it was like still interesting and good, or you didn't really give a shit? Also, what do you think about Oven? Because I think Oven is still there. You know, he killed Pound or whatever. So not only do we got Big Mom on the horizon, we also have Oven. Do you still think we're going to get possibly a matchup with Oven and Sanji? Again, assuming like I didn't totally fuck up and Oven is dead somehow or whatever. But like, what do you think regarding Oven and Sanji? And are you ready to get this cake shit over, this wedding cake over with a Big Mom? I ain't gonna lie. I'm ready for it. I'm ready to move the hell on, give her her cake, and be done with it. And your overall thoughts of the chapter. Again, if it wasn't for Pound and his sacrifice, it wouldn't have been as awesome as it was. It wasn't a 10 out of 10 or anything like that, but I would say it's a solid 7, 7.5 out of 10. And pound for the motherfucking win. Side characters making big moves, so I gotta respect it. And as a father, again, I really appreciated that. And it hit close to home. But that's all I have for this one, though. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. If you liked anything I had to say or enjoyed the video, drop me a like. I'd greatly appreciate it. And if you want more from me, make sure to subscribe. Follow me on Twitter, Instagram, and do a little stalking on my Facebook to get more when the video ends. I'm Phenomenal World, and as always, people, have an awesome day. And remember the golden rule. Anime and manga for life. Have an awesome one, people. By the way, in case you ain't noticed, I don't know why I was just so hyped to talk about this chapter that I'm not even in my regular location right now. I'm just kind of like, I need to talk some One Piece. I fucking love One Piece. Yeah, okay, I'm gonna go now. Have an awesome day.